So have you been doing a lot of signings this year?
Every show I go to, I do a little bit of it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
This is pretty much the only gallery that I've had stuff in that I've actually gotten to go to.
Can you talk just a little bit about the whole concept of summoned? I know you wrote a little bit about it, but was it based off of the that one particular piece, or is it just an idea that's been rolling around in your head?
I mean, the whole idea, I know you thought it was a little bit cryptic, but the whole idea of just the word summoned, as artists, it kind of feels like you're pulled to do one thing or the other sometimes. And it was as much about being an artist and being kind of summoned to do the work that you do as much as it was about the work itself.
Right.
You know what I mean? That makes sense? Sort of.
Yeah. Did you feel that the other artists that you included in the show really got it in terms of?
Oh yeah. I mean, they're all really, really talented and skilled at what they're doing. And, in terms of, I didn't want it to be something that was so specific that it was like, like an obviously themed show. I just wanted it to be very open to interpretation.
Right.
You know.
And do you do a lot of pieces that are sort of like, I know you use yourself as a model for, like the arms or the legs or whatever, but do you ever do any that are actually autobiographical?
That's kind of that's a funny question, because I think almost everything an artist does that's a personal work is kind of autobiographical. And, it's a map of your psyche. So, I guess the short answer would be yes. I do that all the time. It's one of the themes of when I talk to people about how I approach finding the imagery, it's very much, a Rorschach test, and that's the reason they do those is because they're very telling, so yeah, I would say it's very, on a lot of different levels, very personal.
Have you actually done a self-portrait that was intended to be?
Not that I would have pulled out and said, here's my self-portrait. I've used myself in pieces before, but most of the time I end up being a creature,
right?
Or part of a bigger narrative or another scene or whatever. If Beauty were a book piece, that's me. I was the reference for the guy in that piece, but I wouldn't say that it was intended to be just a self-portrait of me.
When you go to signings and things, do you have one particular, if you are doing drawings or alterations or whatever, is there a particular image that people tend to ask for?
Not usually, no. I mean, when I'm doing magic cards, because I've done a lot of magic cards and people want those altered, they sometimes they'll ask for specific things, but there's nothing really that stands out as a theme that people ask for more than anything else.
Do you use family members as models?
Oh yeah, I've done that before. In fact, I did a book cover for a tour where I had to take my 12-year-old, and I aged him to about 15 or 16 years old in the cover. But it's obviously him,
Oh, very cool. So,
and I've also painted him as a baby before too. One of the first oil paintings I ever did was of him as when he was 1 year old.
Aww.
And I have a lot of reference of my little girl, and I have a lot of paintings planned in terms of in drawings with her as well.
Do you have plans for the upcoming year? Any big plans that you can talk about? Or
I'm doing some book work, an illustrated book. It'll have a cover and 6 illustrations for Simon & Schuster. I'm not sure if I can actually say the name of it right now. I just did some concept work that might turn into a longer-term gig, because it was for a series pitch, a TV series. I did that. I just came back from Toronto maybe a month and a half ago. And theoretically, I've been told we're supposed to go back around the beginning of the year, years. But that's always, you know, it's an if. You know, mm-hmm. it might happen, may not. I don't know. But I have my own work that I'm always planning. And I, you know, as much as people have seen, I have more than this at home that I want to do. Sketches that I haven't shown people. You know.
Do you have a dream project that you'd love to do? Like, if you had, you know, time and money was not an object.
My dream projects are basically to sit down and do the work that I like to do. So I kind of get to do that sometimes, along with the contract work that I do. So I wouldn't say that there's a target project. You know, I do have books that I want to make. I have stories that I still want to write and illustrate. And so those are sort of on the table for me right now, too, because my wife is pushing me to do it. Because she kind of likes my writing more than she likes my drawing. So, but it's, and I'm not, that doesn't bother me at all because that I like to write a lot.
Did you see that? I know that, like Todd Lockwood and Brom, and there's been a few others, I think Charles Vest as well. A lot of artists actually have wound up writing as well. And do you see that as a natural, especially for illustrators, bridge back and forth?
I think when you've trained yourself so long to interpret other people's narrative, that you naturally start developing your own narratives for your work. And I think that's kind of a natural association to make. And I think there's a lot of artists with a lot of stories to tell. And so I think some of them are just waiting for the right time.
Right. Yeah. Last words?
Not last words, but how about, you know, last words for tonight?
Yes.
Somebody asked me today what was the biggest piece of advice that I would give people that I would wanted to have heard when I was starting out, and it's don't wait for somebody to give you permission to do the work that you want to do. Do the stuff you want to do now, and then show it to people. And if you love it, somebody else will love it too.
Awesome. So.